This is a video to show the creation of a table within Capstone. First, we'll create a new tab by going to the new page. I'm now going to go to the right-hand side and double left-click on table so that we can create a new table display. Once I've created that table display, I'll go up to select a measurement, left-click, and go down to create new, and then user entered data. We're going to name this data depth. Hit the tab button to advance to the unit section. In this case, we're going to use units of centimeters. Press tab again, and that will move you to the first field in which you can enter data. We're going to enter in simple data here, and you can use tab to enter to advance between the cells within this column. We're going to select top of the second column, select measurement, and we'll go down to create new again, and user entered data. In this case, we'll call this temperature. Again, we'll press tab to advance to the units, and we can call this degrees Celsius. And again, press tab to advance to the first cell, and again, we'll generate some dummy data here. So we now have this data into our table. Let me complete this data here. Now that we have this data, we can now place this into a graph. So we're going to create a graph on the same page by going over to the right-hand side and double-clicking on graph. Once we have this graph displayed here, we'll go ahead and select the vertical measurement, and we'll select depth. Excuse me, we'll select temperature. And then on the horizontal axis, we will select depth. We can see that we have a linear relationship here that exists within the table. One of the advantages of Capstone is if we decide, we made an error on our last data entry here, we can actually change that, and that will dynamically change on the graph.